Yo, what's up, guys? Oh, wow. I just click record and it starts pissing down my rain. That's how Valentine's Day is gonna go, is it? Right, anyway, guys, last episode we built that Carnotaur. In the night, I got busy and I can't fly. Okay. Well, anyway, I got busy. I made these two parasols, you know, Elvis. So there's this dude here having a drink. This dude is stood up looking over. I'm gonna sleep this away because it's just ridiculous. Ignore all that stuff that I've got on me. That will pop up a bit later on in the episode. So since late last night, all the way through to today, and then hopefully this evening, I'll be able to edit this video, and I'll try and get one video out, start to finish, in 24 hours. Kind of show you what I'm capable of. Sorry if you can hear that, there's a dickhead outside that thinks he's a rude boy with his little car, and his big bean can stuck on the end of it. Moving on. So, this is what we made last episode, with a little bamboo farm. It's nothing industrial, but I thought I'd show you. This is what I got from just building those two little dinosaurs. Not amazing, but you know, it's all I need. Really, bamboo's not all that important to me. What else happened? I got pranked. No idea who, but this seems to be the craze. It's quite fitting with what's actually going to happen in this episode. And this, I've already been up there, I've already had a look, that's why it's broken, but Baby Drags has delivered me a shulker box of orange and black concrete. If I can land on it, I'll show you. Yeah. So that's going to come in quite useful. I will head over to spawn and we can get to work. Right, here we go, catch up on a few other bits I did late last night. Now, my fellow Realm member, Pro Wolf, has asked for my help building a shop for his string and his spider eyes. And he started that one on the top and I started the one on the bottom. Hopefully he'll get online and be able to help me finish it off for him, but he's got a newborn, so babies come before Minecraft. I might have to do this one on my own, I'm not sure yet. Anyway, I'm thinking of time-lapsing this. I got some music sent through to me by my buddy Ace Man. It's a remix on an old classic, and to be honest, I'm trying to get him to pick up Minecraft and join the realm, because the dude's awesome. As you can see, Pro Wolf, he's got loads of space here, room out back there for, no staff room or whatever he wants. And this, I believe, is the Mexican red-kneed tarantula. I hate spiders more than anything else in the world. Love snakes, hate spiders, bit weird, I know, but doesn't stop me from wanting to build one. Anyway, enjoy the music. Come back, never be the same. Took a long time, now I'm so high. Don't
nation. No breathing, don't give a fuck if I kill my own bleeding.
That was a tune, man. That was a tune. I used to love that when I was a kid, and now that other dudes got involved with it as well, it sounds so much better. Anyway, right, let's update these and see what the spider shot looks like. Invisible. Yeah, I'm too far away. Let me just run off and sort this out quick. Oh man, there's a giant tarantula like appearing before my very eyes. It's disgusting. Oh, look at that thing. Yeah, let's put that down. I'm well happy with the build, but doesn't make it any less creepy, man. Suppose I better show you quick. And let's fly over to this rancid thing. So as you can see on the maps there, like some of his legs are curled up. He is like sort of on the edge of a cliff, so it's kind of holding on. Looks like Pro Wolf has been in. He stocked it up, but he's still got to do his decorating and prices and what have you. I suppose a pathway up to this guy too. Would you do one pathway or eight? I don't know. Right, if I can fly, which, oh, for God's sake, man. Yeah. There you go, Pro Wolf. There's your shop done. Yeah, spider shop. Best looking spider shop I've ever seen, mate. And I never want to see it again. Yo, anyone else noticed this in the background? It's giving me some real strong Wonderland vibes. I haven't seen a build like it since last season, and I'm really, really intrigued as to what this might be. I can't find a way in or out, but I don't want to spoil anything. This is the realm that just gives and gives and keeps on giving, man. Everyone here is awesome. So Clarky's messaged me. He's got a guardian head that I can have, and he wants nothing for it, except like unconditional love. But you know, how cool is this realm and the people that are in it? Holy crap. Jesus Christ, man, let's have a good look at this. What? I'm going to go poke my nose while I'm here. You know, it'd be rude not to. Alright, so. Oh, man. Up. It goes up again. Mate, it goes up again. This is nuts. Nice view, man. Right, where is he? He was behind me. Right, let's check out this guardian head, shall we? Oh, look at that. That's pretty cool. I wish the spiky bits kind of hung off it, though. Pleasure doing business with you, buddy. There's your unconditional love. He's also got like virtually every villager that you can possibly get in here with like one emerald trades. That is maximum patience right there. And acacia trees with snow on the top. That is the first time I've ever seen that. We've got orders at the wither shop. Let's go see how many withers we got to kill. Ooh, three. Okay, guys, this episode is sponsored by Clarky. Let's get to work getting those stars. Which one are you? There we go. Light on. Job done. Right, so it's around about midday. I've got dinner on the go, and I've got a couple of hours to kill now, so I've got a bit of a space dug out here, and ignore this just for now. But what else I've done is I have finished the fence around the entire perimeter of my base, so it's a bit more like Jurassic Park now. Plus it gives me an idea of sort of how much room I'm working with. Anyway, this is for a future episode. This is going to be the start of the monorail tour going around all these dinosaurs. It's going to be a big long fun ride, and I'm going to charge people to use it. Righty rah, loads of redstone. Anyway, my roast potatoes are roasting, and I'm gonna get on and stick something here. I won't time lapse it, we've already done one of them in this episode, but I'll cut back when it is done. Alright, big reveal time. There he is. Let's go under the trike, under the parasaurs. This is Dippy, the Diplodocus from the London's Natural History Museum. Obviously this one's got flesh, the other one's just bones, but I suppose it's the most famous dinosaur in that museum. Really happy with this one, didn't take long at all. I mean, the shape's pretty much straightforward, isn't it, apart from a little wobble in his tail at the end there. Yeah, I'm really liking that. Love to know what you guys think of him. I've still got a bit more time in the day, and there's a big pile of water there that's sat there empty, and yeah, I don't quite like it. I might see if I can fill it in the time that I've got, and I've still got to edit this and get it out today. I only gone and done it. Right, so I had a bit more extra time than I thought I'd need, so I started lighting up the beachfront, just experimenting with these different sort of coloured blocks too. But there he is. This is an Elasmosaur. It's one of them. It's like got a turtle shaped body with four flippers, but it's got a like dirty great big long neck and a long tail. It looks well derpy from here, but like when you're flying around it looks pretty cool, and it fills up this space quite nicely, and you can climb up on top of this one and like ride him. Can't do that with a Mosasaur. So do some flybys and have a proper look at it. I know you don't see this one in Jurassic Park or Jurassic World, but I was like proper struggling. I've done the Mosasaur and here we go again. Man! Right. Come on, come. Nah. Okay. Alright. Calm down, don't blow your top. You just have to look at him through the fence. Alright, I'm done with that. Also managed to get some mat work done. So what have we got? We've got Pywolf's base, that's in. Daru's base, that's in. Foxy and Rhea are up there. I had to extend the whole map room to get them in. Pyed, he's well off over there. I'm just about squeezing him in. I've still got a few more to go, but not too bad. Anyway, I need to go update the maps for my base. Right, there we go. It is around about 8 p.m. now. I started work on that spider yesterday. So yeah, about 24 hours roughly. This episode, I think, we've got the Elasmosaur, we've got Dippy, we've got the fence, we've got the gate. All I need to do now really is the Indominus and the monorail, and I think that's quits on dinosaurs, and I can start digging underground and do farming and base work and stuff like that. Yo, don't forget to like, share, subscribe. Hope you have a good day or a good Valentine's Day. Peace out, everybody. See you in the next one.